now, verse 18, and this is a new section in this chapter. Here you have Paul's charge to Timothy, and it's his personal charge to him. And as we have said several times now, that this letter is a personal letter of Paul to young Timothy, although he is talking about the local church and what he's to do in it, how he's to behave himself and his responsibility. It's very practical, and yet it reveals something of that wonderful relationship that must have existed between Paul the Apostle and young Timothy, as well as young Titus, as we'll see later. And also, there must have been many other personal friends of Paul. And wouldn't you like to have been a friend of Paul's? Well, he says to him here in this personal charge, verse 18, "This charge I commit unto thee, son Timothy," it's his spiritual son. Paul had led him to the Lord, "according to the prophecies which pointed to thee." Now, Paul is saying something here that he didn't discuss too much with others, or with the church at large, that actually Paul felt led definitely to take this young man Timothy along with him. Paul had a spiritual discernment, and God apparently directly led him to take this young man and bring him into the position that he apparently occupied in the early church. "These prophecies which pointed to thee, that thou by them mightest war a good warfare." And when you go into war, and this is something that our nation has just learned the past few years, you ought never to fight a war unless your heart's in it, unless you're fighting for a real cause, unless you intend to get a victory. And Paul says here, "I want you to fight, that thou mightest war a good warfare." You've got a real enemy. And he had already talked to the Ephesians about that enemy. And Timothy knew about that enemy. It's a spiritual warfare. And now he says, "I want you to fight a good fight," because some were not fighting a good fight. Some were making shipwreck of the faith. Listen to him, verse 19. "Holding faith and a good conscience, which some, having put away concerning faith, they've made shipwreck." And I take it here that you have a tremendous truth. And it has to do with, I think, our intricate personalities. I get a little weary today of those that want to make the gospel so simple that it's sort of like turning a green light on, and then a red light comes on, and that's about all it is. When the green light's on, you walk. When the red light's on, you don't walk. And it's that simple. It's not quite that simple. And what he's saying here is this. There is a danger of you and me in our inconsistency and our failures. And I take it that you're not living in some ivory tower somewhere. And some Christians are today. They feel they are way up above the smog of the landscape, and they're way up yonder. Well, those of us today that are walking the sidewalks of our cities and living here and rubbing shoulders with rough humanity today and the problems of this world, we find out that there's inconsistency in our lives. There's failure in our lives. Now, what is the danger? The danger at a time like that is that you and I accommodate our faith to our failure. And you hear so many people say this today. A man came home from the mission field, and he got a job doing something. He told me, he said, "The Lord led me to do this." Well, I said, "You were trained for about 9 years to go as a missionary. And now the Lord's led you back off the field to do something that actually wasn't very important." And I said, "Do you really feel that that's the way the Lord leads?" "Oh, yes," he said. He was confident that the Lord had led him. Now, he mouths that so much, and he still mouths it, that I'm of the opinion that he has now accommodated his faith to his failure. May I say, that's the grave danger. My friend, when you and I fail, when there's that inconsistency in our lives, we ought to go to Him. Let Him know we've fallen short. We haven't measured up. And after all, we're going to see in this next chapter, He's a wonderful mediator between God and man. We're going to talk about that now in a few moments.